Rational expressions. Now, rational expressions is just a fancy math term for fractions. Whenever we're dealing with fractions, we like to reduce them to simplest terms. So when we're dealing with fractions with variables in them, there's a basic process that we go through that's pretty much the same as any other process for dealing with fractions. And the first thing we're going to do is factor. So we're going to factor each of these expressions first, and then we're going to cancel any common factors that exist between the numerator and denominator. So looking at the first one, we first need to factor this numerator. So in order to do that, I'm going to consider 2b squared minus 9b minus 5 as its own term to factor. Now, since my a term is not 1, I'm going to have to do this with the AC method. So I'm going to make a sum product box. My sum will be negative 9, so this term here. My product is 2 times negative 5, which is negative 10. The two numbers that give me that would be negative 10 and positive 1. So that's going to be what I split my middle term into. When I do that, I'm going to get 2b squared, which is my first term. When I split my middle term, it'll be minus 10b plus 1b, or just plus b, minus 5. I'm then going to check to factor this by grouping. From this first group, I have a common factor of 2b. Leaves me with b minus 5 plus 1 times b minus 5. So it seems that b minus 5 is my common factor. So I'm going to factor that out. B minus 5 times 2b plus 1. So that's what my numerator will factor to up here. So I'm going to cross this off and rewrite it in factored form. 2b plus 1 times b minus 5. And now I'm going to deal with factoring the denominator. So let me erase some of this superfluous work down here. Back to my pen. Do the denominator a different color. Notice this is a difference of two squares situation, so it will factor to 2b plus 1 times 2b minus 1. So that's what I have down here in the denominator. Now we can look to cancel like terms or like factors. 2b minus 1 will cancel with 2b minus 1 because they are the same, which leaves me with b minus 5 in the numerator and 2b minus 1 in the denominator. So there is my reduced fraction. Notice that I'm not going to cancel this b here with this b here because those are not factors of the numerator or denominator. They are linked with these other terms by these operations of subtraction. You can only cancel when the operation between the two factors is multiplication, which was as it was here and here. It was 2b plus 1 times this, 2b plus 1 times this, so I was able to cancel those two out. For the second one, we're going to go through the same kind of factoring process. What makes it slightly more challenging is that the denominator here is a sum of two cubes. So I'm going to rewrite this in factored form next to it. Using that difference of cubes or sum of two cubes formula, I end up with 4m plus 1. 4m is the cube root of 64m cubed, and 1 is the cube root of 1. And then it will be times that first term squared, which would be 16m squared, minus the product of the two terms, which is 4m, and then plus last term squared, which is 1. And my numerator is, again, I have to factor using AC method, so I'm going to do that below in blue. When I go to factor that, I'm going to have a sum and a product. My sum is 8, my product is 16 times 1, which is 16. The two numbers which multiply to 16 and add to 8 are 4 and 4. So it actually seems that this is a perfect square in the numerator. So we'll actually factor to 4m plus 1 4m minus, I'm sorry, plus 1 again. It's a perfect square. And then I can look to cancel my like factors, which would be a factor of 4m plus 1 in the numerator and denominator, leaving me with my simplified version is 4m plus 1 divided by 16m squared minus 4m plus 1. My simplified fraction. Okay. So that's simplifying rational expressions or simplifying fractions. Now, if I was multiplying and dividing, it's pretty much the same process because as we multiply, we can also simplify. So I'm going to look at these. I'm going to factor these rational expressions before I begin the operations. So my numerator is a difference of, or sum of cubes again, so that's k plus 2 times k squared plus 2k plus 4, using that sum of 2 cubes formula in the numerator, and I have k minus 2 in the denominator, so that's this first term factored. Now I'm going to factor the second term as well. I have k plus 2 divided by, and my denominator factors to, it's a perfect square, k plus 2 squared, k plus 2 times k plus 2. And my operation between these two terms is multiplication. So why we factored it first, because if I multiply, all of these terms will end up as factors of the numerator, and all of these terms in the denominator will end up factors of the denominator. So I can cancel as I multiply. So I can cancel k plus 2 with a k plus 2. I have another k plus 2 here, which will cancel with another k plus 2 here. And I'm left with k squared plus 2k plus 4 divided by k minus 2. There's an accidental negative there. Let's undo that. Plus 4 here, and k minus 2 in my denominator. Final answer. So I can simplify as I multiply. It's a shortcut that helps you save some time. The reason the second one is slightly more difficult is that we have a division. Well, division is just multiplication by its reciprocal. So I can rewrite this question as x squared plus 3x minus 4 divided by x squared minus 4x plus 3, and instead of divided by, I could write it as times the reciprocal of my second term. So reciprocal of my second term would be x squared minus 9 divided by x squared plus 2x minus 8. So I'm going to factor each of these and simplify as I normally would. My numerator here factors to x plus 4, x minus 1, getting those terms from what multiplies to negative 4 and adds to 3, so that'd be positive 4, negative 1. So down here we're looking for what multiplies to 3 and adds to negative 4. Well, negative 3 and negative 1 will do that, so this will be x minus 3, x minus 1. Their product is positive 3 and their sum is negative 1. For the second one, this will be multiplied by, that's a difference of two squares situation, x plus 3 times x minus 3 divided by what multiplies to negative 8 and adds to 2. Well, that'll be 4 and negative 2, so this will be x plus 4, x minus 2. Once I have everything factored, I can look to cancel my like factors, so my x plus 4 factor will cancel with my x plus 4 factor, my x minus 3 with my x minus 3, my x minus 1 with my x minus 1, and I'm left with just x plus 3 divided by x minus 2. Simplified. So whenever we have a division, remember to change it to a multiplication and take the reciprocal of your second term and then simplify normally. Adding and subtracting rational expressions is when we first start to consider the least common denominator. Now we're going to look at three ways of using the LCD, because the LCD is just a tool to use in simplifying and solving equations. So knowing how to find the LCD is key, and then how to use it appropriately in each of the three different situations. So the first type of situation is when I'm adding and subtracting a rational expression, which looks something like this. So we're going to find the LCD, get each fraction over this LCD, and then combine, just like we would normally do when we're combining fractions. So the LCD, in order to figure it out, is the representation of each of the factors from the denominator. So I'm going to factor my denominators. My first one factors to x plus 2 x plus 3, So that's my factored form of this. And then my second one factors to x plus 2, x minus 2. That's what this one will factor to. So I need to represent each of these factors. So the first factor I need to represent is x plus 2. So x plus 2 will be a factor in my LCD. I'll also need an x plus 3. Okay. Then I'm going to check my second denominator to see what else I'll need. Well, I need an x plus 2, but I already have that here, so I don't need another one. And I need an x minus 2. So x minus 2. So that's what my denominator will look like. So I need to get both of these fractions over this LCD, which is x plus 2, x minus 2, x plus 3. Well, in order to get these over them, I'm going to need to multiply these fractions by their missing factors. So my first fraction, this one, is missing a factor of x minus 2. So I'm going to multiply this fraction top and bottom by that missing factor to get it over that denominator. So I'll have a 5x times x minus 2 as part of this fraction. And then my second one, it is missing the x plus 3. So I'm going to have to multiply this fraction top and bottom by x plus 3. X plus 3 in the numerator and denominator. So I'll end up with a negative 3x. Negative 3x times x plus 3. And notice where that denominator one is going. It's x plus 2 times x minus 2 times x plus 3. That's exactly what this denominator is. Similarly over here, x minus 2 in the denominator is x minus 2 times x plus 2 times x plus 3, this denominator. That's how I'm able to combine these into a single fraction. From here, I'm going to distribute and combine my like terms. So this will be 5x squared minus 10x minus 3x squared minus 9x. Remember to distribute that negative sign. All divided by this LCD, which I'm going to kind of cheat here and copy it. Copy, paste. I'm going to drag that over here. I'm actually going to paste it again, because it's going to have to use it one more time. Okay. So I'm going to combine my like terms in my numerator, and I end up with 2x squared minus 19x. I'm going to check to see if there's any factors in the numerator that will cancel with factors in the denominator. The only factor in the numerator is an x. If I factor that out, I don't have any like terms, so I can actually just leave this exactly as it is. That is my simplified term. So we found the least common denominator, we got each fraction over it, and then we combine them. Complex fractions. Now this is when I have a whole bunch of fractions put together. Again, this is going to be a process that uses the least common denominator, the LCD. But the LCD, what we're finding here, is the LCD of the smaller fractions. The smaller fractions are each of the component fractions in here. So notice that when I make my LCD in this case, I'm going to need this denominator, so I need a factor of x. I'm going to need this denominator, so I need a factor of 3. And we're going to need this one, which is a factor of 3 and a factor of x, both of which I already have. So it looks like my LCD is just 3x. Now what we do in this case is multiply top and bottom or numerator denominator of the entire larger fraction. So it's this numerator times 3x and this denominator times 3x. And the reason we do this is that when we distribute, all my denominators should cancel out and I'll get a simplified fraction. So 3x times 1, 3x times this, will give me 3x times 1, which is 3x. 3x times 1 over x, my x's will cancel out, and it'll just be minus 3, divided by 3x times this first term. My 3's will cancel out and leaves me with x squared, minus 3x times 1 over 3x is just 1. So the whole point of this process in finding the LCD and multiplying by the LCD was to get rid of these little fractions and leave me with just one big fraction. From here, I simplify just like I simplified in everything else. I'm going to factor. My numerator has a GCF of 3 times x minus 1. That's pretty sloppy, so I'm going to write that again. My numerator is a 3 times x minus 1. My denominator is a difference of squares. That's x minus 1 times x plus 1. When I look to cancel my like terms, I have an x minus 1 and an x minus 1 in my numerator and denominator, so this whole thing reduces to 3 divided by x plus 1. Okay, so unlike before the LCD, we're still finding an LCD, but we're using it in a different way. And there is one final way to use the LCD, which is solving fractional equations. When you solve a fractional equation, we're again going to find the LCD, but multiply the entire equation by the LCD, so that we can get rid of all the denominators and just have a simplified equation to solve. So again, let's find the LCD. The LCD, in this case, or least common denominator, is of each of the fractions I have. So I'll need a factor of x minus 2 from the first one. I'll need a factor of x minus 3 from the second one. And I will need, notice that this will actually factor to x plus 3. Sorry, this is a plus, I wrote minus. X minus 2, which is the same two factors I already have. So it looks like the LCD is x minus 2 times x plus 3. Now notice what happens when I multiply this entire equation by this LCD. Let me get some of this stuff out of the way first. There we go. Okay. So I'm going to take this entire equation and multiply by x minus 2 times x plus 3, the LCD. Well, I'm going to have to distribute that to every single term here. So let's distribute it first to the first term. Well, the x minus 2 and the x minus 2 will cancel out, leaving me with x plus 3. Then I have plus. When I distribute this to this term, again, I'll have some cancellations. The x plus 3 and the x plus 3 will cancel, which will leave me with x minus 2 times 3. So that's 3 times x minus 2 equals. Well, we noticed before that this factored to this. So x minus 2 divided by x minus 2 cancel out. X plus 3 divided by x minus 3 cancel out, and I'm left with just 4. So the whole result of this process, by multiplying the entire equation by the LCD, was to get rid of all the denominators. Then I'm just left with a quadratic equation. Distribute this 3 and combine my like terms. On my left-hand side, I end up with 4x, and then it'd be plus 3 minus 6, which would be minus 3, equals 4, which means that 4x equals 7, or that x is 7 divided by 4, or 7/4. So that's each of my three situations when dealing with fractions. I have fractional equations using the LCD, complex fractions using the LCD, and rational expressions using the LCD. All different ways, but using the same tool, but in three different ways.